This segment of Hack 5 is brought to you by Jack Threads.
Hey guys, so we're back from South by Southwest, and whoa, the lazy boy is moving. I'm over at God's Flaw's place, and we're having fun with code. God's Flaw is here. Say hi, Chris.
Hello.
And anyway, I just figured I'd show you how to get started with Kill All the Humans. So I'm looking at the GitHub here, and I guess we'll just go ahead and start by doing a git clone. And then the address to Kill All the Humans, and it's going to go ahead and download a copy, all the latest and greatest from here. And if I ls now, I can see I have a new folder called Kill All the Humans, and there's my executables, there's the daemon, as well as makefile, the readme, and you know, I can cat the readme and find out that I'm supposed to drink all the booze, hack all the things, and kill all the humans now. So as far as getting started is concerned, like, pretty much just cat the install. And there's some additional things in here that I'm going to mention, but that'll probably be in here by the time this gets committed back in. First of all, we need to be root, and none of that pseudo shit. We need the real thing. So we're in Backtrack 5, and it's no big deal because we already are. So now we need to do cpan, which is like, what is it? It's like Perl module installer happy doohickey thing.
Yep.
And pretty much just hit enter through this if you've never done it before. It's just going to basically walk you through setting up a bunch of stuff, and you'll get to this prompt here where you'll type in install, and we need this module called POE, and that's not power over Ethernet, it's what is it? What is POE?
It might be the Perl Object Environment, I think is
oh,
the
name. Yeah, that's right, we did look that one up.
Yeah.
And that does, what, just executes code really quick? What does it do?
Yeah, so it's this event-driven framework for Perl. It basically allows you to do a lot of non-blocking I/O and whatnot, so there's sort of almost a little like spinny scheduler, and as it's sitting there blocking on a read from a config file, the second it gets data from that config file, it spins up the little code widget,
like,
that's going to do exactly
like
what
the second it's going to do that.
Right. Yep.
So does that fix the problem we were having when in like 0.2 or whatever, where we were like, oh, should we use fstab or udev? And we got to the point where we had to like wait 60 seconds for it to grab it.
This basically makes it happen almost immediately.
Cool. So pretty much just keep hitting enter. All of the defaults are going to be sane, and it might take a bit. It's going to want to do some network tests, and you know, in just a few minutes you'll have this module installed.
Audible.com is the leading provider of downloadable digital audiobooks and spoken word entertainment. Audible has over 75,000 titles to choose from to be downloaded to your iPod or MP3 player and played back anywhere, anytime. Choose from books in every genre: science fiction, thrillers, drama, comedy, business, history, and more. Here's one that I liked, A Clash of Kings. The second season of Game of Thrones will be on TV soon, and the first book was so good, you have got to listen to the second one too. Go over to audiblepodcast.com/HAK5 to get a free audiobook download of your choice when you sign up today. Again, go to audiblepodcast.com/HAK5 for your free audiobook.
All right, so our module is installed. We can just go ahead and issue quit, and let me cat my install again, see where we are. So we have POE installed, and now really it's just a matter of running make install. And once that is done, we're gonna go ahead and make sure that this executes every time we boot. So we could really F ourselves up if we don't do that. So really it's just a matter of doing update-rc.d, and then we wanna tell it kill all the humans, and then defaults. Now, the first time we set this up, we need to go ahead and start the daemon manually. I see, like, if I do, like, pit of kill all the humans, it's not going to find anything. So, /etc/init.d is where it's living, and we just run kill all the humans with start. And if you run it with nothing, you'll see all the parameters it'll take, you know, start, stop, status, restart. It's like a regular service. And so we just say start. And now it's started, first time, right? So now you're wondering, okay, cool, now how do I get, you know, all the GPG key magic stuff happening? Where's the wizard, whatever? This is the cool part, and this is where, like, Chris gets all the props for that, because really all I do is take a USB key now. Whatever USB key, you kind of want to make sure your system didn't have any before you started that process, and just go ahead and plug that in. and that's it. It's done already. Like, boom, done. And I will notice, like, a window didn't pop up in Nautilus or anything, and I will have to, like if I go to /MNT and LS, I see now that I've got this folder called, so I go into Shadow, and there we go. If I LS tech LA there, you'll see I now have this new file here called shadow.gpg, and that right there is my private key. So if I come over to /etc/killallthehumans, I will see my humans.key, and if I cat that, there you go, there's my private key. Enjoy. And so now I can just go ahead and unplug this, and if I reboot my machine, I will not be able to log into it unless I plug this in, and as soon as this gets plugged in, because it's using PoE, it's going to be super fast, and I'm going to be able to just like type in root. You guys know my password, Tor, because I just installed Backtrack 5 a second ago. Maybe want to do that and then do full disk encryption on top of that. And now we've got second factor authentication, 0.4 or whatever version we ended up on when we were at South By. And so hit up Chris's GitHub. So where is that, Chris?
So that's going to be github.com/godsflaw/killallthehumans.d in order to grab the software.
Awesome. Later.
Hey guys, so this is just a really quick public service announcement about Kill All the Humans D. So if you wind up running this, know that it's in extreme alpha version, and there's probably a bunch of weird little things that you may wind up trying to do that aren't going to work very well. Once everything's been initialized, if you change your password, it won't actually update the encrypted file. So for that session, you're fine, your password's changed, but the second you pull your stick out and you plug it back in, it reverts the password. So I leave that as an exercise for the reader.
What about SSH with keys?
There's a weird side effect with SSH. So if you do key authentication with SSH, what you wind up getting is so even if you're not using a password, if you SSH in while the stick isn't in, for some reason SSH will bounce you out. So even if you're you have an authorized key, a public key in your authorized key file, it just doesn't work.
You think it's hitting PAM?
It could be. I'd have to actually watch. It'd be interesting to turn off any sort of password authentication and see what happens. I don't know how it plays with other USB sticks. So once you've initialized the whole thing, I never really went through and said, hey, what would happen if I had multiple USB sticks?
It probably just does an RMRF on all of your media.
That's it.
Probably. Yeah.
So use at your own risk. It will kill all the humans.
That just about wraps up this episode of Hak5, but you can follow all of us, including Kirby, who I believe is at Kirby or at Hak5Kirby on Twitter, over at hak5.org/follow, and of course hackshop.com is where Shannon is hooking up the fun gadgets and t-shirts and cool stuff like that from Hak5. She'll be back next week. We're all in studio, and I hope you guys have enjoyed this. So hit up feedback@hak5.org. Let us know what you think. And was there anything else? Did you need to add something? No. No, you just want some treats. Yeah, I thought so. All right, we'll see you next week. I'm Darren Kitchen. That's Kirby. Trust your technolist. It's the Comprehensive Pearl Archive Network.
All right,
hang on. Here we go.
Is it recording?
Waiting 2 seconds for child process to settle. You always have to wait for the children to settle down, you know?
Yep.
Don't make me pull this process over.